Good morning, students. Today let us learn about the poem The Camel's Complaint, lesson 3 from literature book. Before going to the poem, let us know about the poet. The poet name is Charles Edward Carryl. He was an American poet who wrote for children. He was a wealthy businessman and a stockbroker in New York and wrote poetry for amusement. He is known to write in the style of Lewis Carroll, the author of the famous Alice Adventures in Wonderland. In this poem, The Camel's Complaint, the poet explains about the complaints of a camel. This is full of the complaints of a camel. It complains about the food given to it, the place it sleeps, the home given to it, people riding on it, and about its shape. These are the main complaints of the camel in this poem. Let us go through the poem. Canary birds feed on sugar and seed. Parrots have crackers to crunch. And as for the poodles, they tell me the noodles. Have chicken and cream for their lunch. But there is never a question about my digestion. Anything is okay for me. In the first stanza, the camel complains about some animals and birds. Let us learn about this. Canary birds feed on sugar and seed. This means we give or we provide some sugar and seed to these canary birds because they eat only the sugar and seed. So we give them sugar and seed. Parrots have crackers to crunch. Parrots eat crackers, so we give them crackers. Crackers means a biscuit. And as for the poodles, they tell me the noodles. That means the poodles is a kind of dog and they eat only the noodles and chicken and cream. Okay, so we give the noodles, chicken and cream for their lunch because they eat these only. They like these very much. So we provide them these all. But there is never a question about my digestion. But we never ask what the camel eats. So the camel takes everything. Camel eats everything. So camel is complaining that no one is asking about my favorite food, what I eat. And anything is okay for me. I eat everything because nobody is asking about my digestion. So I take everything and the people also think that I take or I eat everything. So never they ask any question about my digestion or about my food. In the second stanza, cats, you know, can sleep in a chair. Chickens can rest upon rails. Puppies are able to sleep in a stable. And oysters can nap in pails. But no one supposes a poor camel dozes. Any place is okay for me. In the second stanza, he complains about the resting place of some animals. First, he complains about the cat. The cat can sleep in a chair. Then he complains about the chickens. Chicken can rest or sleep upon rails. And puppies are able to sleep in a stable. Then he complains about the puppies. We give shelter to puppies for sleeping. And oysters can rest in pails. Pails means buckets. But no one supposes a poor camel dozes. And he tells that no one is asking about the resting place of a camel. Camel has no place to take rest. And they think that they can sleep anywhere. And any place is okay for camel. Lambs are indoors, out of the sun. Coops are built for hens. Kittens are treated to houses well heated and pigs are protected by pens. But a camel is handy wherever it is sandy. Anywhere is okay for me. Next, he complains about the house we build for other animals. Lambs are indoors out of the sun. He says that we keep lambs always inside and never they go in the sunlight. Coops are built for hen. Next, he says that we build coops for keeping hens. And kittens are treated to houses well heated. Then he again complains that kittens are treated to houses. We make houses for kitten also. That also well heated. Okay. Always we make houses for these all animals. And pigs are protected by pens. We make pens for protecting or keeping pig inside. But a camel is handy wherever it is sandy. But they are not making any houses for camels. Wherever he sees sand, he sleeps on the sand. No one is asking about his house or no one is making a house for him. Anywhere is okay for me. He complains that people think that anywhere is okay for me. I can sleep anywhere. So they are not making any houses for me. People would laugh if you rode a giraffe or rode the back of an ox. It's nobody's habit to ride on a rabbit or to try to ride a fox. But as for a camel, he carries families. Any load is okay for me. Next, he says about the load he has to carry. He says that he has to carry a lot of load also. Why? People would laugh if you rode a giraffe. We can't ride on a giraffe. We are not liking to sit on a giraffe and ride it. And the same, rode the back of an ox. We never like to sit on an ox to ride also. And it's nobody's habit to ride on a rabbit. Anyone can sit on a rabbit and can ride? No, nobody likes to ride on a rabbit also. And or to try to ride a fox. Nobody likes to ride or sit on a fox also. But if camel is there, everyone will be ready for sitting on his back. And he has to carry the load also. Human also. Human means they are not coming single. They are coming with their families also. And they all are sitting on the back of a camel. So he has to carry the load also. No one is asking about the load also. A snake is as round as a hole in the ground. And weasels are wavy and sleek. And no alligator could ever be straighter than lizards that live in a creek. But a camel's all lumpy and bumpy and humpy. Any shape is okay for me. In the last stanza, he complains about the shape of camel. All animals have its own good shape, but camel is lumpy, bumpy and humpy. A snake is as round as a hole in the ground. Snake can find its shape as round as it can adjust anywhere else. Means mainly in the hole. They can adjust their body shape. You all have seen a snake, how it is moving. Okay, and how it changes its body shape. And weasels are wavy and sleek. These animals are not straight but smooth and shiny. And it also has a fixed shape. And no alligator could ever be straighter than lizards that live in a creek. Here their shapes are also fixed. They cannot change their shape. Okay, alligator and lizard. both are in a flat shape. They cannot change their shape. Their shapes cannot be changed. And they are also satisfied with their shape. But a camel's all lumpy and bumpy and humpy. But how the shape of a camel? The shape of a camel is lumpy, bumpy and humpy. Lumpy means no shape. There is no shape. Bumpy means high and down, not smooth. And humpy means, you all know, a rounded raised part on the back of a camel. That is called a humpy. Totally he says that he has no shape and he is not satisfied with the shape given to him by the God. And all people think that he is okay for that shape. In this chapter we have learned about the complaints of the camel. And this is the nature of humans also. We never be satisfied with whatever we have. We will always complain by comparing ourselves with others. It is good or bad? It is not good. We must be satisfied with whatever we have. Okay, student? The God has given us shape. We are not able to criticize about the shape. We must be satisfied with the shape we have. Okay, I think you all have understood the poem. Let us end today's class here. Okay, thank you.